So, hi everyone. So I'm going to present a joint proposal with Arthur Winkelmann. So you all know the blockchain, you all know the proof of work, and there's an ongoing concern about the fact that proof of work are difficult to produce, and you're going to solve a challenge that's more or less useless in the sense that finding a nonce so that for a fixed prefix, the hash of the nonce and the prefix is going to have enough zero, that's not really helpful. And so that's a waste of time and energy. And also, what you do is reference only the previous block. So if for some reason this block is dropped, all your work is for nothing. So what we are proposing is proof of ability. So proof of ability, the interesting idea is that the challenge is going to be any open cryptographic problem. So that if you solve it in some way, you are contributing to science. So that's great. We don't want to have a linear flow. You are going to reference several previous blocks so that even if one of those blocks fails, you're still going to exist. And that's going to end when there are no new crypto problems. So hopefully not soon. And that's nice. Every time you solve a problem, you are going to create one or more new problems. So normally it's never going to end. So how are we going to do that? In fact, the solution already exists. So proof of ability is going to be something that can fit into roughly 30 pages. You can use unlimited headers, appendices that nobody is going to read, and you can, in fact, ignore them. Then those proofs, you're going to bundle them together, because that's nice, and you are going to want to proceed them, so that you're going to call that some proceedings, and you want to publish them, so you're going to use a deputy publisher, so if you, that's an authority, so if you translate that into German, you're going to end up on Springer Verlag. And now that we've gone paperless for the proceeding, we can produce lightweight notices of cryptography solutions, so the famous LNCS series. So that's quite nice. You produce one new block every year, but you are going to be able to run several blockchains concurrently. So you can do cross-reference between the block and the blockchain. So that's quite a neat feature. So however, that's still a work in progress. So there are still many improvements that we can do. So in the current model, there's no really direct reward for the block reviewers. And in fact, it's only the publishers that's getting all the credit and literally the credit behind the paywall. The verifiability sometimes should be improved because some of the blocks kinda are going to be dropped. And one of the main questions is how many blocks should we wait before considering that a block is going to be secure? And one of the work that's still going to be that can still be debated is are the program committees like a proof of cryptographic stake, and which community is going to win the next conference? So I hope you paid attention during the presentation. There have been several announcements from new block generation, and don't forget to submit and contribute to the great crypto blockchain. Thank you.